Have you ever wondered how Quirrell managed to find Voldemort? Or what kind of job you could have if you were in the wizarding world? Now that we've introduced you to the wizarding world, you've probably got a few questions.
Why is it when something happens, it is always you three?
Well, wonder no longer. We have all the answers you need. Well, maybe not all the answers.
Why spiders? Why couldn't it be follow the butterflies?
Keep watching for the answers to all your burning questions. Why don't Muggles get a Hogwarts letter? Well, first of all, they definitely struggle to keep up in charms. But the real answer is that only witches and wizards can attend Hogwarts School of witchcraft and wizardry. No non-magical folk are allowed to set foot on the grounds under magical law, as we explained in a previous video. There is an international statute of wizarding secrecy that forbids wizards from spilling secrets about their world to non-magic folk. This unfortunately applies to non-magical children who are born to magical parents. This kind of person is called a squib. You've met one already. That's right. Argus Filch, the Hogwarts caretaker, is a squib, and seemingly the only exception to the rule on non-magical folk allowed onto the Hogwarts grounds. Squibs can often feel isolated and out of place, especially if they can't attend Hogwarts with their siblings. There was one occasion where a squib tried to join his siblings at Hogwarts. He even managed to get as far as the sorting ceremony. However, the hat politely reported that the boy wearing him was a good-hearted chap, but no wizard. Why can't Muggles discover such a big school? Hermione would be disappointed to hear that you haven't read Hogwarts A History. If you had, you'd know that the castle is bewitched to look like an old ruin, with a sign on it reading, "Danger, do not enter, unsafe." Other large wizarding locations, like the Quidditch World Cup Stadium, have muggle-repelling charms on them to prevent any unexpected visitors. They are also bewitched to be unplottable, meaning it's impossible to plot it on a map. The list of things magic can hide from muggles is never-ending. Speaking of which, how do people go through the wall to platform 9 3/4 undetected? As Stan Shunpike once said,
"Muggles, they don't see nothing, do they?"
Haven't you ever noticed something strange out of the corner of your eye, then turn to see there's nothing there? That's what a lot of wizarding secrecy relies on. Muggles being too lost in their own lives to notice anything out of the ordinary. However, there are usually some plainclothes ministry officials hanging around the platform to deal with any muggle memories that may need to be altered.
Obliviate!
How did Quirrell find Voldemort? Quirrell had a hard childhood. Despite being very smart, he was relentlessly bullied in school and was desperate to prove himself in adulthood. This led him to pursuing the dark arts, and eventually, setting out to find what remained of Lord Voldemort. While his intelligence meant he was able to track down the dark wizard, Quirrell's naivety and arrogance betrayed him. He believed he would be safe in an encounter with Lord Voldemort, especially since the Dark Lord would be very weak. However, when Voldemort realized that Quirrell had a position in Hogwarts, he possessed the professor to do his bidding. Quirrell was powerless to the Dark Lord's will, and ended up being controlled by him for almost an entire year. This was a valuable lesson for any wizard planning to seek out Lord Voldemort. However strong you think you are, you're no match for his power, even in his weakened state.
Harry Potter!
What other jobs exist in the wizarding world? The short answer? Loads. The wizarding world is just like ours. There's something for everyone. The best place to start is the Ministry of Magic. Here, you could train as an Auror, one of the coolest, but most dangerous jobs you could have.
Tonks, for God's sake.
Aurors are essentially dark wizard catchers. They protect the magical community from danger. While it is a job that often puts them in harm's way, it's incredibly rewarding, too.
What are you doing?
Rescuing you, of course.
Both Harry and Ron have said they want to be Aurors when they leave Hogwarts, and it's fair to say that they have the experience needed. Don't worry, there are lots of other, less life-endangering jobs available at the Ministry. For example, Ron's dad works in the Misuse of Muggle Artifacts office. This leads to some strange questions.
Tell me, what exactly is
the function of a rubber duck.
Oh.
If you like traveling, you might want to apply for a job in the Department of International Magical Cooperation. This could lead you to a visit at Makuza in New York City with American wizards. Outside the ministry, there are jobs more similar to those you'd find in the Muggle world. Obviously, you could be a teacher or a healer.
Out of my way, out of my way!
You could get into journalism like Rita Skeeter, or even work in a pub. More magic-focused jobs include Wandmaker, though this can get messy. If you're really brave, you could be a dragon keeper like Ron's older brother, Charlie.
Tell me, what would I get if I added powdered root of asphodel to an infusion of wormwood?
Well, if Hermione had been given the chance to answer, she would have told Professor Snape that this combination creates a sleeping potion so powerful it is known as the Draught of Living Death.
She's perfect!
However, Snape might not have just been testing Harry's potions knowledge in this scene. In the ancient art of Victorian flower language, plants have symbolic meanings. Asphodel is a type of lily. In Victorian flower language, it means, "My regrets follow you to the grave." Wormwood means absence and symbolizes bitter sorrow. When combined, their meaning can be interpreted as, "I bitterly regret Lily's death." How heartbreaking is that? How did the Philosopher's Stone appear in Harry's pocket, and what happened to it afterwards? It was as surprising to us as it was to Harry when the Philosopher's Stone, the object of Voldemort's desire, suddenly appeared in his pocket as he stared into the mirror of Erised. Usually, this intriguing mirror shows the onlooker their heart's deepest desire.
Only I'm head boy, and I'm holding the Quidditch Cup.
But in Harry's hour of need, it presents him with the stone. It was Dumbledore who made this possible, by making modifications that turned it into the perfect hiding place. Only someone who wanted to find the stone, but not use it for its powers of immortality, could locate it. As for the fate of the stone itself, Dumbledore spoke to his good friend Nicholas Flamel, and they agreed it should be destroyed. Immortality sounds good in theory, but someone like Lord Voldemort would be too tempted to use it for evil. Hopefully we've answered your most burning questions in this video. If you have any more, well, it's the perfect excuse to reread the books and rewatch the films to find what you missed. Thanks so much for watching Discover Harry Potter. Head over to our channel for even more exclusive content from the Wizarding World.